Continuing the brain gym algorithm exercises for looping or repetition logic. So these are brain gym repetition or looping logic assignment problems. There are total about 8 or 9 problems. I have divided it into 3 parts, part 1, part 2 and part 3. In part 1, there are 3 problems. To help you solve them and develop the logic, I am going to explain what the problem is expecting from you. So the first problem is trying to say, write an algorithm to print all numbers between 1 and n which are multiples of both 6 and 10. What it's trying to say is, given a series of numbers starting from 1 till some endpoint n, you need to only print those numbers which on division by 6 and 10, the remainder happens to be 0. So if you take any of these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, if you try to divide by 6, the remainder is not going to be 0, as well as division by 10, the remainder is not going to be 0. So the first number you can think of which is divisible by both 6 and 10 happens to be 30. 30 mod 6 is 0. 30 mod 10 is 0. So you will print 30 on the output screen. So what will happen is, user will give the end point. So starting from 1, you will keep checking every number whether it is divisible by 6 and 7 using the mod operator to find the remainder. If the remainder happens to be 0, then you will print such a number. That's problem number 1. Problem number 2. Okay. So what it's trying to say is, in problem number 2, given an input positive number, I need to keep multiplying it by 2 or doubling it and find out how many times I doubled or multiplied it by 2 till it touches or just crosses 1 million for the first time. So let me tell you what I'm trying to expect here. Suppose I have a number 2,50,000. The count is 0. I double it, the count becomes 1. Now I double it, the count becomes 2, but the number has also reached 1 million. So I am going to print this value of count on the output screen. Now let me come to the last problem. This is a really interesting one. What it says is, a famous conjecture states that given any number, if the following rules are repeatedly applied, okay, then the number eventually becomes 1. Now, I'll just give you a hint. Before even explaining this problem, you can easily solve it using the repeat until loop. If the number input is even, okay, divide the number by 2. If the number is odd, multiply by 3 and add 1 to it. Continue this process and sooner or later the number will finally reach 1. The thing what this algorithm is asking you is, it is asking you to show all the steps in the middle. Like suppose, let's say I take a number input as 10. Then since it's even, it becomes 5. Okay, 5 is odd. So 5 becomes 5 into 3 plus 1 becomes 16. Now 16 gets divided to 8, 8 gets divided to 4, 4 gets divided to 2, and finally number becomes 1. So you need to show me all these 10, 5, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1 steps. In the sense, you should show the output on the screen. A better example in a larger font. Suppose the input number is 5, then it becomes 16, then 16 the number becomes 8, it becomes 4, it becomes 2, and then it becomes 1. So if you take any number and do these even and odd treatment, finally that number is going to be 1. So this is a very famous conjecture implemented via programming. You will enjoy the process of programming when you see these intermediate steps. So in the repeat until loop, every time make sure you print the number so you will know what is the value of number as it is going to 1.